The Core Human Resource Development or Road Asset Management Program is a JICA long-term trainee project implemented as a part of the LAMP project. One purpose of this project is to deepen understanding of technologies related to road asset management among long-term trainees in various countries by providing them with opportunities to acquire knowledge and skills related to these technologies at graduate school in Japan, and get a first-person look at the status of effort in Japan and the field of human resource development. Another purpose is to contribute to development of human resources who will one day play a central role in road asset management in their home countries by building personal connections with government officials and experts in R&D experts in Japan. The target of this program are experts in developing countries, including current government officials and technical officials in charge of road administrations and road operation management in governments, as well as university faculty members in the field of road asset management. In Japan, besides studying in a doctor's or a master's program at a graduate school, trainees can observe the effort conducted by Japanese expressway companies, Japanese local governments, and universities. They can also participate in issue-based training in the field of road conducted by JICA and do internship at corporations. Participation in this program requires document screening, interviews, and written exams. Applicants who pass these examinations are invited to come to Japan. There, they will study for 2 years in the master's program or 3 years for a doctoral program. And after returning to their home country, they will put their knowledge and experience to use in asset management of local infrastructure, such as roads and bridges.
I can provide the study that related to advanced technology for the bridge maintenance that can make improvement of the quality for the maintenance cycle of the road asset management. Especially our technologies may lead the preventive maintenance. Those JICA students have great motivation for the learning of studying for the road asset management in my university, so that the student aggressively participate any seminar provided the, not only the both the JICA and also my universities.
I belong to the Ministry of Works and Human Settlement, where there are different departments. And the one department is the Department of Roads, where it looks after the construction, maintenance of the roads and bridges. So I worked in one of the construction sections under the regional offices. My major is under the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering, under the Disaster Reduction Division. So the main core subject here is related to the disaster reduction. So like the geological condition, and then other thing is about the bridges. So like especially focusing on the steel bridges, and then the properties, and then the strength of the steel we can know, so that is more helpful while doing the maintenance work back in our country. In Bhutan, we do plan to have the road asset management system. So after having the road asset management system in place, so I plan to join as a committee member or like say members in those system to contribute myself for the development or the improvement of the maintenance system in the country. So And back in my country, I always encourage my friends and everybody to participate in any upcoming scholarship provided by JICA or other agencies.
JICA students can learn the advanced research and the technology through coming to Japan, and the student can bring the knowledge that they could learn in Japan to their home country. Japanese universities have benefit to accept JICA students because Japanese researchers may be able to implement their research on actual field where JICA's students' home country.
The researches, the characteristics of our researches is that remote the monitoring. As you know, Nagasaki the area has the largest number of islands, and also the second, the longest, the coastline in Japan. We have so many bridges and other kind of the road assets in the remote area. Such kind of the bridge linking the outlying islands. The backgrounds of students, participants are diverse, as well as the situation and the condition of their countries. But anyway, they are full of the motivation and a sense of missions.
First of all, I belong to Egyptian National Institute of Transport. Ministry of Transport in Egypt established in it to be a center of consultancy for transport education, training, research, and consultancy. I successfully passed all PhD courses in the first year. Also, after a long discussion with my supervisor, Nishikawa Sensei, I finalized my research plan. It was about developing deterioration models of pavement management condition for Laos National Road Network. These models, it will be helpful for eliminating the expenses for collecting and obtaining data and analyzing the field data. Also helping the decision makers in planning, setting priorities for maintenance and rehabilitation actions for deteriorated roads. As well as I participated in many short-term training courses managed by JICA. With these courses, I learned I got much data about road and bridge management technologies, especially in Japan and other countries. I am working on developing pavement deterioration models for national roads network in Egypt and transfer technologies for data collection and pavement inspection to Garbled. This is a general authority for roads and bridge and land transport in Egypt.
In this program, it is important to have the deep and careful discussion with students in order to set the appropriate and reasonable research topic according to their interest and request. This is a kind of the policy of us for this program. So the aim of such a policy is to obtain the research activities and the achievement, which contributes to solving the local issues. So this is a small size technical cooperation project.
As part of JICA's Road Asset Management Platform, RAMP, 24 long-term trainees from 19 countries have already come to Japan, where they are studying at 10 different universities. By having the government officials and engineers actually involved in the maintenance of roads and bridges come to study in Japan, they can consider maintenance from the time of construction leading to high-quality infrastructure development in developing countries, where infrastructure development is just getting underway. They will also become important partners for Japanese organizations that will conduct infrastructure-related business abroad in the future. In that sense, I think it's important for us to ensure that the trainees bring Japanese technology and knowledge back to their countries, rarely come to Love Japan, and stay in touch after they return to their home countries.